That's okay. The reason that that occurred is clearly because I put in your name wrong. There we go. See, that was the problem. That wasn't actually North in front. It was an evil twin. An imposter, an interloper. Trying to sully North and Tara's good name. Hey, little Sharky. How's it going? Alright. Antara, just don't F it up. Easy. Wow! Takase with $5 on Behemoth. Whew. Little did Takase know that North and Tara knows how to fight. Yeah, Little Sharky, it's actually a really fun speed game. I would say the RNG in this game is just bad enough that you can't really take it seriously and grind it down. But it's not so bad that as long as you don't take the game super seriously, like, you can have fun with it. Yeah, no kidding, Takase. That was a very quick bet loss. I mean, if I'm being honest, I wouldn't have bet against the Behemoth. Just on any given day, the Behemoth is probably gonna win. So far, North and Tara has not taken a nap. I feel like I should point that out. There we go. That would have been bad. I did not want to run there. Play the best version and the hardest version of Final Fantasy IV without patching it. I honestly don't know. I'm not sure what the correct answer to that is. I know that the PlayStation version is supposed to have abysmal load times. So I have to imagine that that's not the version that anybody's going to recommend. I feel like I've only seen speedruns on the Super Nintendo version. Which leads me to suspect that that's probably what you want to stick with. There you go. PSP is most complete. There's a Chrono Trigger port for PlayStation, I believe. I think that they made like a bunch of extra anime-esque cutscenes and stuff for it, if I recall correctly. They even added a bunch of in-game stuff. That's cool. I didn't know that. Oh, PS1 was Final Fantasy plus, 6 plus Chrono Trigger. For some reason, I thought that it was like 5 and 6 or 4 and 6. One of those two. Out, but not the way that I wanted to use my heroes. Yeah, I thought that the PlayStation game was 5 and 6. Because that's when the really, really bad... translation was released. It was like nowhere near as good as the RPG translation. That bomb was just in case. You never know what's lurking right behind a door. No, doors are evil. You never know what their intentions are. Thank you. North and Tara, no. They don't. Final Fantasy storylines and worlds and all that stuff are all discrete. There's no overlap between them. Hey, CS Thomas 2, how's it going? Yeah, yeah, like Nolpin said. There are certainly direct sequels. Like Final Fantasy X-2. Final Fantasy IV The After Years. Which is perhaps not quite as well revered as... some of the previous Final Fantasy games have been. That's fine. Cool. CS Thomas, I feel like you might be in the minority with that particular opinion. I don't know a ton of people who really enjoyed The After Years. I personally have not played it. But it certainly has a reputation of being something of a Kuso game. I think that we're okay to not dupe, although we do have to use one. Should have duped there. Yeah, North and Tara, I would be really hard pressed to give you hard and fast rules regarding what the properties that make something definitively a Final Fantasy game are. Summons? Did one have summons? I don't think it did. And I think that we can all agree that Final Fantasy I was for sure a Final Fantasy. Dupe a seed here. Thank you. Yeah, one had an airship, but I don't recall Cid. But yeah, I think it's probably fair to say that Cid showing up in a Final Fantasy is indeed something that most people would associate with being a Final Fantasy. Oh gosh, if Ultros has to show up, then we only have one Final Fantasy, period. I don't think that the High Wind was ever in a Final Fantasy prior to 7. Oh, Ultros was in 14. Interesting. Six, 13, 2, and 14. Oh, interesting. I didn't know that. Seven's the most modern Final Fantasy that I've played, not for any not for any reason other than that I have lacked the system to play anything later than that. I don't think that I have a choice here. Split for Squidite. Perfect. definitely wanted to set that bomb off there. Let's get rid of those two first, and then I'll let her revive me. Hey, Faizu, how's it going? Yeah, we're doing some Mystic Quest. Final Fantasy VI did not go well. Could you not? We're literally 3 hit points away from death. Perfect. Oh, jeez. Yeah, that's a heck of a time commitment, all right. Okay. That sure is one way to do it. Why I thought that was supposed to go right at first. Yeah, Eve, as far as I'm aware, is just spaceships. I should not be considered a authority on the matter, though. That's unfortunate. Really unfortunate. There we go. I've done that before, too. Yeah, I'm not into Eve, but I really enjoy reading about things that happen to Eve. Well, this is a time loss. The movement is deceptively slow in this game. There we go. Yeah, I love, like, when something major happens in Eve, I invariably love reading about whatever it is that happened that was, you know, always super ridiculous and took tons of planning and was filled with intrigue and, you know, like, there's a real human element to reading stories about Eve, and I'm sure that there's a real human element to playing it as well. I believe that. I'm not big on MMOs though, so Eve doesn't really have much appeal to me. Back in. Thank you. is. It's fine. Probably gonna heal again. Yep. Go. Still a gold split? Holy crap. Oh, Evo's fantastic. I'm not sure that it's an RPG, or an MMORPG, though. Almost bad. Okay. Yeah, I remember reading about Project Entropia, gosh, a long, long time ago. Is that still around? I'm sure it is. It seemed like it was making money. Hey, Angel's Prayer. How's it going? Oh, you got a Trinitron for your speedruns. That's awesome. I hope you like it. I definitely love mine. My PVM's really, really good. At this point, I know that I'm going to have to use seeds, but that's fine. I don't like it here. Too many earthquakes. Oh, nice. Your SD Disnest shipped today. That's awesome. So since you mentioned speedruns, what are you planning on running? CRT projector is for gaming. I mean, my gut feel is that if it's a CRT and it's not doing additional processing to the signal that it's getting, then it's probably going to be just fine. SMW96 exit. Nice! That's a super fun category. Thank you. Yeah, once you said 96 exit, it it sparked my memory. I'm not going to use that as an excuse not to say nice things about the SMW community, though. Okay, now it's Spencer's Cave. Yeah, Scepter K, overall, I found the SMW community to be super, super awesome. Friendly, welcoming, typically quite good at helping people who are new to the game learn it. My right arm has been bugging me since Alive Forest. I've been just dying for more dialogue that I could mash through so that I could scratch it. Yo, Pwexel. Thank you for the good luck on finding the OG Jerkbird. My PB has Jerkbird on 4-6, so let's see how this one goes. Yeah, pretty much a guaranteed red split at the Pazuzu split. Yeah, Angel's Prayer. I think that pretty much everybody lurks in Poexel's stream. Easily one of the best streams to hang out in on Twitch. Why would I wipe you? Because it works, apparently. Excel streams are super comfy. Mm. doesn't work against them. Good to know. Oh, wait, no. That's because I'm an idiot. That's why. Oh, no. Yeah, I can imagine the bridge mummy fight taking a little while at 1 HP. Hey, Starscream, how's it going? I mean, I didn't anticipate that result myself, no. Drin Snow, there are a lot of things that you can expect to see on this stream. A world record in a game that I've been running for a week and 2 days. Probably not one of those things. I appreciate your faith, though. It's incredibly kind of you. Heaven Chaos, good evening to you as well. and Lasso. How's it going, everyone? Lasso, I agree with you. This is indeed the most majestic of quests. Also, I feel it's worth pointing out, North and Tara has spent way less time face down in the mud than average, so, you know, good job for that one. Hey, Half. Thank you very much. I hope that you are also having a... that's unfortunate. Having a fantastic and mystical evening. I'm glad to hear that today's gone well for you, Hap. I mean, you have been basically named the Mr. Rogers of video games, so that seems pretty good. I don't think this works. No, that doesn't work. Not even a little bit. I mean, it'll be a two-turn kill, whatever. I say two-turn kill. Apparently I meant three-turn. What you get for being lazy. No, we go up. Not a safe thing to do inside of a tree. Mm. All right, sir. Thanks for hanging out. I hope you had fun. Thank you for the good luck. That's a bummer. Let's go ahead and do that. Nice. This should kill both of them. Or not. Please just die. Thank you. Door. Nice. Oh no, Scepter. I hope that you have a wonderful power nap, and I hope that your workday goes well. Thanks for hanging out. I hope you had fun. Rude. Yeah, that's fine. So, I think this is it? This for the next one. Skulgan, I have not appeared on the Frame Savers. Good point. Yeah, I can use auto instead of manually doing that. Totally forgot about that. I don't believe that there's a way to skip the boss for this stage. It's certainly not in Ilmagus' guide. Hey, cool. Yeah, this run's going okay so far, but keep in mind that my PB had a 4-6 Pazuzu, so it's gonna I'm gonna have to get really, really lucky not to end up in the red after the next split, no matter what happens. Yeah, that's a mine, which we do completely skip. Which is why, if you look next time that I open my inventory, if you pay attention to it, you'll notice that it. I'm gonna seed up right here, so you'll have a chance to see. I've got coins in my inventory. That's definitely not supposed to happen. Oh, I didn't know that skipped. That's super cool. Could you maybe not? It's boss. It's boss though. Let's do this. Yo, Dwingo, thank you very much for the host. I hope that you're doing well today. Well, Final Fantasy VI ended on the Veldt, and this run, Pazuzu decides whether or not PBs. If Pazuzu is on 6, we PB. If not, I'm going to finish the run, because it's the polite thing to do. Should have used seeds there. Well, for that exact reason. Hey, Kurt, thank you very much for the subscription. It's super, super appreciated. Because not only does that support the stream, and I definitely appreciate it very, very much. But on top of that, all the money that I get from this stream gets sent directly to the Extra Life charity campaign that's linked in my stream info. So you're making me feel really good on the inside, but you also get to feel really good because you're helping sick kids. I feel like that's a cause worth helping. Yeah, Skulgan, I also would have assumed that Beholder is a back then it would have been a TSR property. But, you know, maybe not? Somehow? I don't know. That's unfortunate. Good news. The Windows tablet that I'm using so that I can try and have notes up for Pazuzu's Tower, it's got an update ready. It really wants to restart. Please just let me hit you with a bomb. Oh my gosh, this fight. This fight should not take this long. Oh, the Hellway is going to be bad. Hey, Ricky is trying. How's it going tonight? I feel like Eye Guy is a pretty good alternate name for a beholder, but I feel like Eye Guy has to be done within the context of the Mario universe. That was totally unneeded. Colonel Panic, thanks for hanging out. I hope you had fun. Staircrow, that's a good one. Hell, wait time. Let's go. No. I didn't want you on auto. I wanted you using life. You're about to use life now. Not a good start. Yeah, odds of this ending in tears is quite high. This is bad. Take the L here. Hey, Incident 73, how's it going? Much better. I'm doing well. Really looking forward to finding out whether or not this run is going to PB. We get to find out very soon. Roll the dice. Gotta roll the dice here. This is gonna be an L, though. Yeah, that's gonna kill me. There's no other option there, but to try. Yeah, the Mana Core is a meaner version of a Sphinx that you face earlier. You know, that's really just not kind. Could you maybe stop turning my partner to stone? Alright, we're out of the hellway. Alright, everyone. It's time to place your bets. What floor is Pazuzu gonna be on? 6 is good. Any other number is bad. 2 is the worst. I've never seen anything other than 2 or 6. I need to fight that Thanatos. Awkwardly, you think it's gonna be 2. Fair enough. Hey, RPG chick, how's it going? Anywhere from 1 to 6, I believe. that's gonna do it. No, it's not gonna kill those two dudes. This is gonna suck. Or 1, 4, 5. 3.5? Well, that's a guess. Is it too late to change to 9 3/4? It's a little bit too late. That's not smart. It's definitely not what I wanted to target. Definitely should have targeted the manacore. Not 6. Heaven Chaos. Having gone through TIS 100, my best recommendation is to do your best to build out a really solid spec. If you can explain in plain words what it is that you want to accomplish, then you should be able to create a, that would have been bad, a flowchart that you can use to convert into code. RPG Chick, absolutely, you can offer me a hint. This is not a blind playthrough. This is me being bad at video games. Really? Oh gosh, well that's super good to know. Am I worse at video games or programming? Definitely worse at video games. I am solidly mediocre at programming. That's up. Oh, yeah. That's real obvious. It's super obvious. I have to start looking at maps though. Does not please me. So bad at this game. Yeah, thank you for pointing that out. That's super obvious. I definitely appreciate it. If this were like a blind race, then of course backseating would be something that I'd ask you not to do, but... No, that's good. Yeah. Did I verify for sure that... I think I did. I think that's a one. Either that or I'm gonna be very embarrassed. But at least I won't have a ton of fights to deal with on my way back. I didn't see him on any other floors. I'm 99% certain that I was close enough to check. Pretty sure it's a 4-1. If it's not 4-1, I'm prepared to feel really, really silly. You know... This is going to be a death. I mean, unless you do silly stuff like that. Cool. Oh, you can just exit? I'm not going to do that. I specifically am not going to do that because I'm not smart, among other things. Okay, this is bad. Let's flare life. Yeah, let's do that. Take a while. All right, let's try this again. Should have paid attention. Oh well. Yeah, I'm not confident enough to make that gamble. I want the free walk back up if I'm wrong. Okay, well, I should have exited. I can still PB, though. Yeah, I can still PB if this... this fight goes well. Which, I mean, it's probably not gonna, but... That's fair. That actually ended up working out really well. Shield now. Fair. What? I thought auto is supposed to know whether or not you can... defense. The notes do specifically tell me to leave her on auto during... Pazuzu's, thing. That actually worked really well. This will get the flare off. Gamble. Cool. I feel like I always beat that turnout when screw it. No, I assume that we were gonna cure both before and after Pazuzu's turn. Oh, yeah. We're almost system. I mean, technically still PB-able. I'm so mad about that first fight still. Probably still faster to just do that. Hey, you get a heal. Nice. You're still on auto. Definitely not auto. Yeah, I got that potion for that other overflow. Or underflow, technically. Thank you. fair. Hey, Mothman, I'm doing pretty well. How about yourself? Lagging really bad. I hope not. OBS doesn't think that I've dropped any frames. Sorry, I think that this one might be on your side. That's fair. Seems like a totally reasonable thing to do. Oh, that was lucky. Yeah, no kidding. Fair. seems just fine. See, and this is why this is a comfy speed game. Because if I were taking this seriously, like, this would be really frustrating. Yo! Ah, thank you very much for the host. Welcome, everybody. I'm not good at this game. Get to move on. Mm. Fair point, Glexel. Welcome, everybody. I appear to be rolling the dice better than Glexel did one time. Yeah, Eric, all of the music in this game, seriously, is really, really good. The sound work that went into this game is just ridiculously high quality. Hey, Cloudy One, how's it going? Shellender, thank you very much for the good luck. Wherever you're off to, I hope that you have a wonderful time. Oh gosh, you know that somebody cool just went offline when all of the auto hosts roll in. Well, let's hope fire works. Nope. No, fire was not the right choice there. There were many potential choices, but fire was the worst of them. No, I deserve this. There we go. Alright, let's try this again. Here's what we're gonna do. Spell. Meteor. Spell. White. Prayer. Life? No, I mean, life would have been smart. But, I mean, that's... You're asking a lot of them here. Please let Meteor work. Super comfy, Mr. Bing. Like, on a scale of comfiness, we're not even using a scale. That's how off the scale it is. Didn't anticipate that. Pretty sure he was gonna die that turn, but you know, whatever. Last one. So mad. Yo, Seawolf, thank you very much for the host. Welcome everybody from Seawolf's stream. You might be seeing a PB. RNG can still ruin it, so we'll see what happens. Thank you. Hmm. Let's try that turn once more. We should be good to go now. As long as he doesn't do his drain attack next turn, we're good. Yeah, we're good. Cool, PB. Are we still up to race this weekend? I think that would be super comfy. Yeah, thanks for the GGs, everyone. Yeah, and GG especially to North and Tara. Thank you again for the sub. Oh, did I just bop you off? Yeah, we've got a race now. No, Eric20S. So Auth and I did a blind race Saturday, I think. Not this past Saturday, but the Saturday before. And since then I've done 4 runs, including this one, and another race against Auth. So yes, it is fair to say that I haven't done a lot of runs. Also, our blind race was just playing the game blind. We didn't use any of the speedrun strats, and that race was like 10 hours, 11 hours, somewhere in there. Super fun, though. But yeah, it turns out that this is a really, really good, like, low-key speed game. The RNG is such that, like, you'll drive yourself up the wall if you try and take it seriously. But if you just play it casually and you don't really stress over, you know, necessarily grinding it super down, then yeah, it's super fun. It's a perfect sort of speedrun to do nothing but no reset runs in. Far rightmost column is fractional seconds because, for some reason, Live Split running under wine does not want to display the period. Like, a decimal point just does not display, except in the very large, the large number, for the running time. But yeah, it's fractional seconds. Look, I'm running under wine. I mean, what do you want? I'm grateful that it runs at all, because the other option was me writing a splits program, and I didn't want to do that. Hey, Hockey, welcome back. I'm going to assume that you ate a burger because I PB'd. No, I agree with you. It is funny. It's funny, but also sad. Yeah, this updated the sum of best. So my sum of best is now 220.07. That's true, there's always landfare. I have not had a great experience using it. Overall, I think that I like Live Split Under Wine better, even though it has a bunch of, like, slightly weird, slightly annoying behaviors.